Dear students, I happily welcome you all to our algebra class today. Students, today we are going to start our next new session, section 2.11, another counting principle. In the initial portion of our syllabus, we have studied one section with the name counting principle. A counting principle. This is another counting principle. So count பண்றதுக்கு இன்னொரு principle கூட அவைலபிளா இருக்கு அப்படினு சொல்லிட்டு ஆதர் வந்து இன்னொரு principle வந்து கொடுக்கறாரு. So in the beginning, the author is defining one relation, right? So tilde னு சொல்லிட்டு ஒரு relation-அ define பண்றாரு. If a, b belongs to g, then b is said to be a conjugate of a if one condition is satisfied. So first of all, you have to take two elements. A comma b belongs to our group G, and we can say b is a conjugate of A. B is a conjugate of A, right? மாத்தி இருக்குதாது A is a conjugate இல்ல, B is a conjugate of A. If there exists an element, another element, C belongs to G such that, so B is equal to C inverse AC. B is equal to C inverse AC. So we will denote simple letter in the match. A related to B. This relation tilde, our pair is the conjugacy relation. The relation to pair is the conjugacy relation. So A and B are group player. A tilde related to B. A tilde B. The conjugation, A is conjugate, the relation, right? So the relation conjugacy true aagudna inge irukku namakku b is equal to c inverse ac, b is equal to c inverse ac for some c belongs to g. So this is the definition for the relation conjugacy. Next lemma 2.11.1, conjugacy is an equivalence relation. So namakku na define panni solla in the relation vandu or equivalence relation. So in the previous classes I have defined given the definition for equivalence relation. Equivalence relation means you want to prove reflexive property, transitive property, and then symmetric property. If you prove the three properties, then we can say the corresponding relation is an equivalence relation. So first let us prove the reflexive property. Reflexive property. So reflexive property proof pannadhukku ena nama prove pananum, we want to prove A tilde related to A. A conjugacy to A for all A belongs to G, right? So idha nama modhalla solluvom, we know that we can write A as E inverse AE, where E belongs to G is the identity element of the group G, right? So nama definition paarenga, A related to B nu solanona B is equal to C inverse AC for some C belongs to G. அப்ப இங்க நம்ம என்ன சொல்லிருக்கோம் பாருங்க, இந்த A related to இந்த A னு சொல்லணும்னா the A is equal to E inverse AE for some E belongs to G. E identity element கட்டாயமா G ல தான் இருக்கும். So E belongs to G. From this we can say A related to, okay, so reflexive property over, then we want to prove the symmetric property. So next let us prove the symmetric property. Second one is symmetric property. So for that, let us take two elements. A comma B belongs to G. What do you want to prove? You want to prove A related to B implies B related to A. This is our proof. So this is our proof. Now, A related to B implies, A related to B na, there exists one C belongs to G such that B is equal to C inverse C. So we can write B is equal to X inverse X for some X belongs to G. For some X belongs to G. Okay. Now let us simplify this and let us prove B related to A. Easy as simplify பண்ணிடலாம். B is equal to இந்த பக்கம் X இருக்கு. அதை X eliminate பண்ணுறதுக்கு we can multiply both sides by X inverse. B X inverse is equal to X inverse A X inverse, right? For some X belongs to G. Sorry, X X inverse. One multiply. So B X inverse is equal to X inverse A X inverse, and another identity, right? side identity E only multiply by na even or x inverse A. Now we want to eliminate x inverse. If they eliminate one, no? So let us multiply both sides by x inverse the whole inverse. X inverse side matana multiply one. X inverse the whole inverse B x inverse, which is equal to x inverse the whole inverse x inverse. Right? So in the number of here I will go. So here the right. That implies x inverse the whole inverse B x inverse, which is equal to x inverse the whole inverse in x inverse and I don't know E in the A, that is equal to, right? So what about this x inverse? Now x belongs to G, right? X belongs to G. Now inverse is equal to x inverse of G. Then I have another name for it. Let y is equal to x inverse belongs to G, right? So in the substitute, then we can write y inverse dy which is equal to a. Side of the table, a is equal to y inverse y. From this what you can say, for some y belongs to g. From this we can say b related to. So initially we have taken a related to b and now we have proved b related to a. Hence tilde relation is a symmetric relation. Next let us prove it is a transitive relation. Then next let us prove the transitive property. So for that we want to take three elements. A, B, C belongs to, right? So nama enna prove pananum, A related to B and B related to C implies A related to C, right? Now A related to B na B is equal to x inverse AX for some x belongs to G. Similarly artha kadunga, அடுத்தது என்னது B related to C. B related to C implies C is equal to some Y inverse B Y for some Y belongs to C. For some Y belongs to B related to C na C is equal to Y inverse B. So I will put it up. Now substitute பண்ணா சிம்பிளிஃபை பண்ணா அவ்வளவு. That implies C is equal to Y inverse B க்கு வேல்யூ சப்ஸ்டிட் பண்ணுங்க. X inverse AX. Okay, so that is equal to associative property true. I have all elements to group layer, so associative true. So we can change the bracket Y inverse X inverse AX. So again, simplifying C is equal to Y inverse X inverse and add it. A, B the whole inverse and B inverse, A inverse. So, O inverse, X inverse na X, Y the whole inverse. Right? A, X. What about this X, Y? Our X and Y are in G. Closure property apply paninga na X, Y yu inga irukko G. So, we can say, so X, Y belongs to G. Yuk vayana na, or name anika kutukko na. Kutukko na, yandral, prava yandral. If you want, you can. So, this is equal to X, Y belongs to putting an angle on the okay. C is equal to Z inverse A is. So from this what you can say A related to C. So transitive property from one meter. Hence tilde reflexive symmetric transitive and thus tilde is an equivalence relation. Okay. Then another one definition is given in your book. They have defined C of A. C of A. The capital C, right? Capital C of A. Set of all elements X belongs to G such that A related to X. Right? C of A is the equivalence class of A. Capital C of small A is the equivalence class of A. Or you can say it is the conjugate class of A. Right? So C of A, if we define padano, adu vandu or equivalence class of A. Innoru pair solikalam, conjugate class of A. இதோட எலிமெண்ட்ஸ் எல்லாம் எப்படி இருக்கும்னா சி ஆஃப் ஏ கண்டெயின்ஸ் செட் ஆஃப் ஆல் எலிமெண்ட்ஸ் ஒய் இன்வர்ஸ் ஏ ஒய் சச் தட் ஒய் ரேஞ்சஸ் ஓவர் ஒய் இன்வர்ஸ் ஏ ஒய் சச் தட் ஒய் ரேஞ்சஸ் ஓவர் ரைட் சி ஆஃப் ஏ சி கேப்டல் ஸோ இனி ஒரு ஸ்மால் சி வருது அதனால நான் அதை ஸ்பெசிஃபிக்காக உங்களுக்கு சொல்கிறேன் சி ஆஃப் ஏயில் உள்ள definition there. C of A is called the equivalence class of A, or C of A is called the conjugate class of A. C of A contains elements of the form Y inverse AY such that Y belongs to G. Then another one definition, G is a finite group, and suppose C of A has small CA number of elements. இதில் உள்ள number of elements, C of A இல் உள்ள number of elements, small CA, C suffix A, small C suffix A, small C suffix A என்னது, அந்த capital C of A இல் உள்ள number of elements, ஒருவள் capital C of A இல் அந்த செட்டு உள்ள 10 elements இருந்துத்து நான் small CA கி வேலி வென்னது 10, right, so the mean, then we can write order of GS, summation, small c. So, இதல்லாம் ஒருமார் கொஸ்டினும் கேப்பாங்க. Capital C of A நான் equivalence class of A or conjugate class of A. Capital C of A இல்லும் elements எல்லாம் என்ன formல இருக்கும்? Y inverse AY such that Y belongs to G. அந்த formல இருக்கும். இன் Capital C of A இல்ல small CA number of elements இருந்திச்சின்னா, order of the group G என்ன? Order of the group G is equal to summation CA, sigma CA. So, இப்படியே symbol வச்சு கேப்பாங்க. இல்லை, அதுக்கு ஒரு கரக்டான value குடுத்து கேப்பாங்க. ஒரு CA ஒரு 10, இல்லைனா CA ஒரு 11, அப்படின் ஒரு number குடுத்துட்டு, order of G என்ன, அப்படின் கேப்பாங்க. So, உந்த மாறு கேப்பாங்க. So, எப்படி காட்டாலும் நீங்கள் attend பண்ணும். So, write the definition properly. Okay, next is another definition. Definition for normalizer. So, this are all the definition. Next is the definition for normalizer. Normalizer N of A, which is defined as set of all elements X belongs to G such that X is equal to AX. Set of all elements X belongs to G such that X is equal to AX. This is the definition for normalizer. இந்த மாற்றின் definitionsும் உன்மார் கொஸ்டினுக்கு வரும். Set of all X such that X is equal to AX. Next is, next dilemma is N of A, the normalizer. Regular N of A is a subgroup of G. We want to prove N of A is a subgroup of G. So, subgroup proof அன்னும் அது conditions எல்லாம் உங்களுக்கு தெரியும். First of all, we want to say N of A is non-empty. முதல்ல non-empty term. We know that E belongs to G. Identity element இருக்குமா? So also, we can write E A is equal to A A E. So, பைதில் என்ன சொல்லியில்லாம்? E belongs to N of A. சொல்லாம் identity element E always exists in the group G. அப்பு E இந்து A நால் என்னதாம் வரும் A. A இந்து E நால் என்னதாம் வரும் A. அப்பு இதில் உண்டு same அல்லும். இங்க உள்ள definition பாருங்க, X is equal to A X என்னா, X belongs to N of A. அப்பு E is equal to A என்ன, E belongs to N of A. And therefore, N of A is non-empty. Non-empty வந்துத்து இன்னாது இரண்டு condition மட்டும் proof பண்ணிடும். What are the conditions you want to prove? To prove, number one, X, Y belongs to N of A implies X, Y belongs to N of A. Another condition, X belongs to N of A implies X inverse belongs to N of A. One by one, we shall do this. Just simplifications, right? That are all the negative. First one, let me take two elements. X, Y belongs to N of A. Look at the definition of N of A. X belongs to N of A, na? X is equal to AX. Adhe mari. Y belongs to N of A, na? Y is equal to AY. And what you want to prove, xy belongs to n of a. அப்படினா நம்ம என்ன சொல்லணும், xy into a is equal to a into xy. அவளவு, வேறு proof. Consider xy into a. Right? All the elements are in the group G. Associated property proof. So, we can change the bracket. X into, that is equal to, x into, what is ya? Y is equal to a. Again, we can change the property, the associated property to bracket change panna, xa into y, that is equal to, what is xa? Xa is equal to ax. Again, associated property holds, we can change the bracket, a into x. What do you have proved? Xy into a is equal to a into xy, xy in A is equal to A in the xy. From this what you can say? Xy belongs to N of A. One proof. Right? So next what you want to prove? Second one. That x belongs to N of A. Abina, apply one of the definition. X is equal to AX. Nama enna proof pananum? X inverse belongs to N of A. We want to say. Abina enna proof pananum? X inverse A is equal to A into X inverse. Avladha proof. So let us prove that. Consider X inverse A, which is equal to X inverse A. For E una potu. X inverse A into E. Identity one multiply panna adhaan. Which is equal to X inverse A. E avadhu X inverse nu potu. Right? X inverse X n podalam, X X inverse podalam. Namma vasathikaga podu. Now we can change the bracket because associative property is true. X inverse AX X inverse. What is AX? AX is equal to XA. Appo X inverse XA X inverse. Again now we can change the bracket, which is equal to X inverse X bracket change pannikonga AX inverse. X inverse, X inverse, identity, A, X inverse. Identity, one multiply panna, A, X inverse. What you have proved? X inverse, A is equal to A, X inverse. X inverse, A is equal to A, X inverse. Na, X inverse belongs to N of A. X inverse belongs to N of A. And hence, N of A is a subgroup of G, right? Okay, that's all for today's class. Study all the definitions. And write and study all the lemma and the theorem. Okay? Thank you, students.